Hello everyone, I'm Rashi Chahil, clinical dietitian at Rosewalk Hospital. With me today, I have Dr. Lavlina Nadir, senior gynecologist, with me.
Hi everyone.
So ma'am, usually people keep asking me this one question. I want to really put this question out to you. Is caffeine really safe?
Okay, so first we need to understand what is caffeine. So caffeine is a non-essential nutrient. That means body doesn't require it. So it is a brain stimulant and also stimulates the central nervous system. So what it does is, it is an adenosine receptor antagonist, which means it blocks the adenosine receptors and doesn't make you feel sleepy. So it promotes alertness.
So ma'am, is it fair for me to call that, you know, it can actually improve your workout sessions and it can also help in weight loss and use as an appetite suppressant?
So it is not an appetite suppressant, it's a stimulant and it can cause a little thermogenesis. So it can help in weight loss and improving performance.
So what is the safe limit for me to consume caffeine? I mean, like, what is the quantity?
Okay, that's a great question, because there is no safe limit for children. Children should be discouraged from having caffeine. At 13 to 18 years, 100 milligram is the safe limit. During pregnancy, during lactation, for diabetic patients and patients with cardiovascular diseases, the limit is 200 milligram. And as a general rule, one should not exceed 400 milligram in a day's time, because it can have side effects. But Rashi, how do people know how much caffeine they're going to consume? Can you elaborate on that, please?
So one cup of coffee that is brewed at home gives you anything between 100 to 110 milligrams of caffeine. One cup of normal tea that is brewed at home again gives you about 50 milligrams of caffeine. Green tea gives you about 15 to 20 milligrams, and a decaf coffee gives you about 2 to 4 milligrams of caffeine. But caffeine is just not present in tea and coffee, it is present in your sodas. So about one can gives you about 50 milligrams of caffeine. And it also, your energy drinks gives you about 160 milligrams of caffeine. Mm-hmm. So you have to be very careful about the choices that you make. A lot of bakery items these days that we get are also being additives with caffeine in it. So a lot of recipes that we've started using have caffeine present. So
and even ice cream has caffeine, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So one has to make healthy choices and be careful about the amount of caffeine. Even during pregnancy, we tell them you restrict your intake to 2 cups of tea or coffee. And during Navratras, be careful how much tea or coffee you consume, because it can really add up. So have a safe Navratra, healthy eating, have a healthy life.
Thank you.